This episode is brought to you by Harry's. New customers get $5 off a Harry's trial set when you go to harrys.com/cag.
Welcome to CatCast episode number 625. I'm your host, GBD, here in Long Island, New York. And as always, we're joined by a man who's not likely to get the coronavirus because he's sitting at home playing 60 hours worth of Ghost Recon games. Wombat!
I guess.
That's the best form of prevention, staying at home and...
Abstinence is the best form of protection.
Single player games.
Mm-hmm. The only hand that's touching my face is my own. Or something.
What?
Although I think your own hands aren't supposed to touch your face. I don't know how this works. Whatever.
You don't know how germs
die.
You don't know how germs travel.
We're all dying in April anyway. You saw that, right?
Oh, what do we have going on in April?
There's some asteroid that's supposed to hit the Earth, like dinosaur level extinction.
Oh, okay.
It's coming.
Okay.
So that's happening in April. So it's like, whatever.
Is it before or after my wife's birthday? That way I decide whether or not to get a gift or not.
I believe it's before,
okay.
Unfortunately, because hers is like 2 days before
that,
mine.
That works out.
Yeah, so.
No, hers is on 420.
Well, I don't think it was like 428. Shows what I, how terrible of me to not remember your wife's birthday.
Cheapy remembers.
Exactly.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I'll never
so
forget it.
So does Pepperidge Farm. Mm-hmm.
Maybe. What are we talking about?
420.
I know. So you get it?
Blaze it.
Oh, it was a...
Yeah, yeah. It was more weed humor.
Uh-huh.
Got
Blazing
it.
The monster machines.
Were you Cheech or Chong in that scenario?
What's the difference? Chong is just like a dumber version of Cheech.
Mm.
Pretty much. A slower version of Cheech.
Wait, Chong's the dumb one?
They're both pretty goofy.
They're just both stoned, I figure.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, I never caught on to that.
Chong.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No. See, so they like to smoke. See, the movie's called Up in Smoke.
Oh, I thought that was about something else.
No, it refers to illegal drugs.
Hmm. The kids
in Colorado.
Love it.
Yes. I remember when I was like in high school and people were like, have you seen this movie?
Up in Smoke is the best one.
Yeah.
They made a million movies. But I think Up in Smoke is considered the best.
I think that's the only one that's considered to be good. There's what? Still Smoking, Nice Dreams.
Have you seen a documentary about it?
No, I have not seen a documentary about it.
You will, though.
Corsican Brothers was on cable a lot in the 80s.
That wasn't good.
Oh, boy.
No, that movie is so bad.
Wow. I had forgotten about that one.
That is a very bad movie. Yeah. So there. How are you, Ship?
Oh, I'm doing fine.
That's good.
Yes. It's March.
Go to any hockey games lately?
I did. I went to another minor league hockey game.
Why? Why'd you go back? What brought you back? I gotta know.
You wanted the bobblehead with the roller coaster guy.
Yeah. So
Or the other way around.
Beast Night.
Mm-hmm.
Which Beast right. is a very the Beast is a very favorite roller coaster that happens to be here at Kings Island in Cincinnati. So mm-hmm. they were giving out bobbleheads for the first 3,000 that have a hockey player. Don't ask me his name, but he's riding inside of a Beast car, and that's a pretty dumb bobblehead. I like the Beast,
and that's what got you to come back.
Yeah. But also, they were wearing Beast, like, special jerseys,
wow.
like, in the game. And then they were going to auction them at the end of the game. And they're really nice-looking jerseys. Like, I don't know if you've ever seen the Beast logo. I know you've seen the Beast logo, actually. I actually have
a bobblehead question for you. So when you go, was it the whole family? Was it all four of you?
No, it was me and a friend.
Oh, you and a friend. Okay. So never mind. I was going to say, did you go leave with four bobbleheads?
Well,
but I guess not.
We did for the Marshall night, the Paw Patrol.
Okay.
But for
that,
this,
you came home.
I just came
home. Wombat wants to know where his
That's what I
are.
I knew what he was asking. And don't worry. I still have your Marshall Paw Patrol bobblehead.
Excellent. That's all I care about because, you know, I'm such a big fan of Paw Patrol. Mm-hmm. I love their theme song.
It's good.
Paw Patrol, pawing here and there and everywhere.
Close.
Paw adventures that we aren't prepared. Mm-hmm. We are the Paw Patrol.
Yep.
Yeah, that's it, right?
That was it. but I've actually wore a Beast t-shirt to one of our Long Island retro... CADcast before.
It was
Oh, is that the one where everyone kept stopping you saying, I love your roller coaster shirt?
That was it.
Yeah.
Remember when that,
did that happen?
Happened a lot?
No, it did not happen once.
So I thought, man, that's a cool hockey jersey.
Yeah.
Maybe I will go and bid on one of these after the game. Like, you stay for the game, then afterwards you get to like go bid on the game worn jerseys. So they, it's the whole nine yards. You get a little piece of paper with a number on it. You go sit in a specific part of the arena. They bring an auctioneer out onto the ice and they start going through these things. And this,
did you decide how high you were willing to go beforehand?
Yeah. Before going, I was like, like a hockey jersey. Like these are nice, like made hockey jerseys. I'm like,
a nice hockey jersey, like if you just bought one in a store, like a professional hockey jersey, would cost you probably $150 to $200.
Yeah, that's what I was somewhere in like the one starting at 125 range. But I was like, okay, like this is like a once in a lifetime type of thing that I would be bidding on. I'm like, these things got to be going for like what, $250? This is like the equivalent of AA baseball. This hockey team.
Okay.
And unlike baseball minor leagues, like if you're not in like the AAA minor league of hockey, you're likely never going to make it. Like it's not where you work your way up like in baseball. It's pretty much like
these guys have jobs.
Yeah, I'm sure they have jobs. I'm guessing. So I'm like, yeah, like $250.
Okay.
That was like, if I can get one for $250, I can explain that to Mrs. Shipwreck and she'll be fine. She'll be fine with it.
Right. You're like, look, honey, they would cost me like $200 just to buy one in a store. And this is like a rare item.
Right. She knows like the Beast is my favorite roller coaster. It's
easy.
It's an easy sell. So the first one of these goes up for bidding. Just the random one, whoever the first one is. Nobody knows.
Right.
First one, $750.
Right.
That was
congratulations.
That was the cheapest. That was the cheapest one all night. One of these things sold for $3,100.
Why
congratulations.
Was that one? why was one of these worth so many times more?
That was the captain of the team. That was the player that was on the bobblehead, I guess.
But
at the same time, it's the captain of the minor league hockey team.
Sure. But he's also a very talented plumber. So.
And I was about to make a similar joke and you beat me to it, you dick.
Yes. Yes.
They were like some of these, they were game used. You like went down and got, you could get your picture with the player and they autographed or whatever. But still, these are minor league hockey players.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That's crazy. That $3,000 number is, I knew the number ahead of time. Uh-huh. You told me like a couple of days ago, and I was way off. Like
I was with you when he told us.
Yeah, yeah, that was crazy. That was just, I don't understand, because I've been to a minor league. I've been to the Rochester Americans, which I believe is the best minor league level, like right before the majors. And you know, I was in college, and I just remember it being like it was very the difference between a minor league hockey team. A game and an NHL game was like pretty stark. Like
you can actually watch
about
you can watch the puck and the players, and you don't lose track of anything at the minor league level. It's like you're fully aware of what's going on the entire time.
Are people more drunk at the that game? Or
well, it was 513 night. So
I don't know. What's that mean?
That's our area code. But it, okay. But what that translated to was $5 craft beers, $1 hot dogs, and $3 cheeseburgers.
Nice.
So people were drinking a little bit, but it wasn't, they have dollar beer nights as well.
Right. Okay.
So it wasn't the dollar beer night.
Right.
But yeah, it was amazing. Like they sold like 35 of these jerseys, I think total.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, they sold them all off the whole, everybody.
Yeah. Everybody, jersey, even players that were no longer on the team. They're like, this guy isn't with the team anymore, but we had already printed up the jerseys.
He farted in the direction of this jersey.
Right.
We put his name on the back. Wow. And the cheapest one was 700.
Yeah.
750.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was the cheapest That's one. Weird. That was the first one when everybody was like not sure what was going to happen.
So they made more money on the jerseys than they made on like the ticket sales?
I think they made at least over half the tickets sales in jerseys.
Seems pretty good.
Yeah.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened. I was just sitting
people
there.
People like that roller coaster.
Oh, they do.
Popular.
Like, I mean, that's what happened was it was like, this is a very regional thing that everybody right. that could possibly want it was in this building at that time.
So do you think a Beast roller coaster jersey is better than, say, I don't know, like a Skyline Chili jersey?
Because that's next. I was thinking that's next. They saw how right? much money they made.
Yeah. Like, what would go for more? In the Cincinnati
it's hard.
Area.
I don't know that anything would in the Cincinnati area.
Or what about one that has the justice, the Hall of Justice on it? Jersey.
No.
A Hall of Justice jersey.
No, I mean, that's cool, but it's not, it doesn't have like the roller coaster enthusiast portion of it.
I understand that, but it is still the Hall of Justice from Super Friends. And fucking, it is a Cincinnati thing.
Meanwhile, these fucking roller coaster enthusiasts have deep pockets. What's happening?
What about Mitch McConnell? What if they put Mitch McConnell on the jersey? He's popular where you are, right?
Just across the river, yes.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Same people. You guys drink the same water.
Straight out of the Ohio River.
Explains a lot. Oh.
We also did an escape room this weekend. Have you guys done one of those
How
before?
How was that? Did you make it out?
Have you done one of those before?
I have.
Okay.
I have also.
Okay.
I did it with my family.
Gotcha.
As did I.
Mrs. Cheapy had a panic attack 5 minutes in.
Okay.
That
was pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Did they lock the door on yours or something?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, there's laws against that now, I think.
Oh.
Like the
I don't know if it was that's not what gave her the panic attack. I think it was just it was stuffy in there.
Oh, okay.
And dark.
We
and it smelled a little.
We solved everything but missed getting out by 5 seconds.
What?
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah. We had everything in like finished, but could not get the key to unlock the last like could not get the key to work in the last like padlock.
Oh god.
Yeah.
Did they just give it to you? Well, I mean,
no, I didn't want it at that point. I'm like, fix your locks.
Right. Give us a refund. You ruined it. You ruined the whole night for everyone right. with your shitty locks.
And they give you like the three clues or whatever. Did they do that when you guys were doing it?
You mean like you can call them?
Yeah, you can
yeah, they did. We didn't use them.
Okay.
Yeah.
We all three that the, we used were yeah. on puzzles that we had figured out, but were not like applying correctly. Like there was one with like we had got gathered like five pocket watches, right? And mm-hmm. we had found like a sign that matched up times with different letters, so it was obviously like, okay, we're gonna put all these pocket watches and get the letters that correspond to them and form a word, and that's gonna go unlock the next padlock. They like three of the times that were on the watches were on the poster, just like straight up, like here's a 9 o'clock, here's a 3 o'clock, here's like a 2:30.
Right.
Got those three. We're staring at these other two watches and the person's like watching us on the camera, obviously.
Right.
Like she understands that we know what we're supposed to be doing. So right. we're like doing that for like 10 minutes. Like maybe we missed something. Like you go around the room, you're looking for something else. We like finally ask, she's like, oh, those other two, they don't quite match up. So you've got to round those to the nearest hour to get those letters.
Did you throw the watch against the wall as hard as you could?
One of the watches didn't even have hands on it. Like they had written in pen where the hands were. It's like,
right.
What? That's not like if you went to like watch like a Sherlock Holmes movie or something and like right. He was like following these clues and then there was just a sudden like, oh, and this time I rounded up by 15 minutes for no reason.
Right. Oh, and Poochie went back to his home planet for some reason. Right. Those fuckers.
Yeah. Did
you give them some pointers on how to run their escape room better on the way out?
No, because I felt bad
because they were all 13 years old.
Well, that as well.
Probably not 13.
I felt bad though because like the there was like a couple that was doing a different escape room at the same place, like at the same uh-huh. time, and they came out like just about the same time we did, and they just like stormed out, and their like game master like came out to like talk to the person working the front desk, and they're like, they just started fighting, and they just like gave up like a half hour in, and just started like arguing with each other. I'm like. All right. Well, we did all right.
Right. I bet that happens a lot.
I bet it does. Especially like when it's a group of just two people. Like you're just doing that as a date. Ooh.
Oh.
That could get ugly.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
I don't think I can convince Mrs. Cheapy to go back to another escape room. Unless it had windows.
There's one near my house. I haven't done it, but my wife and daughter have. They seem to think it's all right.
They have a bus that drives around.
Escape the bus?
It's escape
bus.
Yeah,
that doesn't sound horrifying.
So I think the bus stops while you're doing it.
Oh, okay.
I'm not 100% sure.
Because that would actually be kind of cool. Like, you don't know where you are when you get out, and you're like, what the hell?
Right.
It's like
if you don't solve it in an hour, they just drop you off an hour from where you started.
Exactly. It's like, what the hell are we doing here? Why are we in Connecticut?
Right. The longer it takes you to solve it, the farther away from home you are.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. And if the bus drops below 55 miles per hour, it explodes.
That's dumb.
Oh. I feel like that was a popular concept at some point.
No.
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Pop quiz hotshot.
Man, have you seen the Sonic movie yet, Wombat?
No,
I feel like you're quoting the Sonic movie.
Wonderful.
You went back to see the Sonic movie, though.
I did. I saw the Sonic movie a second time.
A second time, yeah. Obviously. I haven't seen it. I haven't seen it a first time. Maybe one day, eventually. I'm sure I'll see it. But
right.
Not tonight. I'm too busy.
Right.
I backed my first Kickstarter ever.
Congratulations.
I believe it ends tomorrow. So when this show's live, it'll be over. So sorry, right, people.
I'm looking forward to you being disappointed and never using Kickstarter again.
I get it. It's supposed to arrive in like a year. It's a board game. A Marvel board game.
Wait, this is developed by Spin Master?
Yes.
Why does...
Yeah, no. It's got a real backer behind it.
Why?
It's not...
Why does Marvel and Spin
company...
Master... Like Spin Master, for those who don't know, are the creative minds behind the toys of Paw Patrol and the show itself. And they're like one of the most popular toy manufacturers, like right beside Hasbro.
Yeah, they're huge.
And Marvel, huge, if you don't know, is Marvel.
Yeah, why is this a Kickstarter?
Okay, because the CMON company, I'm not quite
come
sure
on.
It stands for something. Come on. Yeah. Come on Games, who are the ones actually designing the board game. They do all of their games via Kickstarter. And I believe Spin Master has the license for Marvel board games. So they're working with Spin Master. But I don't think Spin
Master.
Why do
they have to work
really...
with you, though? I understand everything in that. Like, yes, here's people who design board games. Here's a toy company. And here is Marvel. Where do you come in?
I think it's because Come On always does things via Kickstarter, and I think they just like having that community aspect.
Okay.
I mean, their goal was low.
Sure. They're going to make, like, this isn't
is.
A question of, are they going to make this?
Yeah. No, it's not even a, yeah. Well, the goal was $150,000, and they're at $2.3 million right now. With 17,000 backers, close to 18,000.
It's interesting that these big companies are willing to give away a pretty sizable chunk of the business to Kickstarter just to have this type of... You think it's because of the community interaction?
I think the community interaction is a big part of it, because I think for a board game like this, that's... It's not like, you know, Spin Master also makes 5-Minute Marvel, which is a card game that I have that my family very much enjoys. That's a fairly simple game. The pieces are all cards, and the timer is literally an app to download. It's not even like they put a timer in the box. Right. So I feel like that's a low investment for Spin Master, and they could probably sell that at a nice profit. This game has a complicated set of rules, lots of cards and little pieces, and then they're also making the actual figurines for each character. So it's going to have miniatures, and that's sort of that's a riskier move for Spin Master to make. Whereas if they just have, come on, do it, and do it through Kickstarter, and it's, you know, even if it's a small profit right off the top, they also have, you know, and they're going to sell this in stores also. They're going to have that version also, but right. It won't come with all of the bonuses that this game's going to come with. So there's a lot of Kickstarter bonus characters.
Wow. Pretty great business, Kickstarter.
Now, what? Yeah. How do you get all the bonus characters? You just have to keep pledging up? Oh, yeah, it is.
Okay. Yeah, the stretch goals. Yeah,
$190.
Well, for $190, you get all the expansion packs.
And all these exclusive characters.
No, you get the exclusive characters even with the $60 one.
That doesn't make sense. It tells me for $60, I get three and then the stretch goals.
Yes.
But the 190 version has like a whole
bunch
more.
You can only get... Yeah, you could get Spider-Man in the 190
version.
There's
exclusives in the...
There, in the 190 version, you get... what is it? The actual game plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 other actual games. So, I don't know. It's a lot. I went with the $60 version, which has, like we already discussed, all these stretch goal characters, which at this point is up to like 20. So I'm like, I don't need to spend that much more. Right. And it has a lot of bad guys, and that's really the thing that you want. Because the bad guys are what you're fighting. Those are expansions in themselves. So
I think I figured out why the company's called Come On.
Why?
Because you look at the $190 version, and you go, come on.
Come on. Yeah. So, yeah, that's a lot.
Yeah, but, well, enjoy it. No, enjoy it.
I mean,
in
it
a
looks
year
like
and a half.
Definitely worth the value. It's just, it's a long time out.
It's a long time out. We'll see how it is in a year from now. We'll put a little pin in it. And
right, let's never speak of it again until it
exactly.
comes out.
And when it comes out, I'll take pictures and we'll post it online. It'll be fun. And maybe you'll come over and you can play it with me.
Fantastic, man.
Uh-huh. Or I can bring it to your house.
Wonderful.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, okay, I would do that.
We could
too.
Do both even.
You what? No.
So many games of Marvel United by Come On.
Yes.
Come on over, Wombat.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do some show feedback.
Okay. What Wesley Ellis has to say, tell Wombat he can't say anything about Cheapy playing kids in ping pong and then play Fortnite. I've been playing with my 8-year-old, and 50% of the time I get a victory royale. I feel bad for all the kids getting murked.
Yeah, Wombat, in your face.
Yeah, I got my victory royale for the season last week. A week into the season, I did get my victory royale umbrella. I was very happy.
The big difference is the kids that I'm playing against are skilled players. That's the difference.
So I bet some of these 8-year-olds playing Fortnite are skilled Fortnite players.
Not if you kill them.
No, how dare you?
It's probably...
How
isn't
dare
it,
you?
Don't you think they have skill-based matchmaking in Fortnite?
They used... I've heard mixed. I've heard sometimes they do
don't
and
know.
Sometimes they don't. Yeah, I think it changes.
It's one of those. Let's see. Skill-based matchmaking Fortnite. I'm going to type it in. See what it says.
I think maybe they do in...
Yes, now they have it. As of October.
I think they have it in the Battle Royale modes, but not the Team Rumble modes. So, not that that matters.
Wait, what? Yeah, in Battle Royale, they have it.
Yeah, in Battle Royale, yes. In Team Rumble, no.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's my point.
Okay. Yeah. So, There you go. So, and I got a victory royale this week.
Good.
So,
good
so
for you.
Eat me.
I didn't play any children this week.
Yeah.
I played a 70-year-old today, though.
How'd you do?
I beat him.
Good work.
Yeah, he wasn't too good. But, he's, you know, we're all just beginners.
Speaking of me playing Fortnite.
Fortnite. Oh, I thought you said Fortnite.
Yeah, at Spicer has to say, favorite thing about my CAG friends is the evolution of Wombat into the most hardcore elite gamer of the crew, and Cheapy D and Shipwreck not knowing how to process the change. Face screaming in...
You're reading the emojis.
I'm reading the emojis.
Yes, keep going. No, read the emojis.
Face screaming in zany face. Face rolling on the floor. Laughing face throwing a kiss. Face throwing a kiss. Wombat out there finishing Breakpoint in 2 days. Finishing Fortnite and Rainbow Six Seasons with ease. I actually didn't finish that Rainbow Six season, but I played a lot of Rainbow Six before they had seasons. That's why
you're not getting coronavirus. All this shit's going down in your living room, and there's no time to, shake hands with a sick person.
I was barely home over the past weekend, but yeah, I guess. I can't tell you what I did. I just know I wasn't home much.
Right. Just wash your hands.
Oh, I went to a bowling party. I went to a bowling party. It was a bunch of 8-year-olds, and those kids were so, it was just chaos.
Horrible. Yeah.
Oh, they would like, you know, when the gate goes down to like swish the pins.
Yes.
So the boys realized that if you threw the ball when the gate was down and you timed it right, it would push the ball back to you.
Yeah.
So they did that every time.
So they got another chance.
Just because they thought it was funny when the ball rolled back to you.
Yeah.
They would constantly like walk in front of people as they were just about to throw the ball. Like, it's amazing. Right. No one broke an ankle. I saw one kid literally throw the ball horizontally.
Yes. I've been to these parties as well. I can't even watch them if it's somebody
else's.
And
they didn't. It wasn't like a go into a room to eat the lunch.
Right.
They brought the food out to everybody, so everyone was touching balls and food and balls and food and balls.
Wait, I thought you were okay with that.
I was fine with it. I just could picture you throwing up.
Well, yeah, yes. I mean,
all of that.
Yeah,
I couldn't. I know, like, the proper. I mean, I took bowling lessons when I was younger, so they taught us the proper bowling etiquette. There's like a whole. It's like driving, you know, like the right of way, who gets to go first, and all that shit. So, like, if the kids are like running in front of each other, like that would.
Oh, yeah. They were just like, they would literally, like, well, kid would be about to throw the ball, and one kid would walk and stand in front of him going,
right.
Whose turn is it? He literally just threw it horizontally across three lanes.
What was
in
the
front
birthday?
Of people.
What was the dad doing? The birthday dad?
I don't know. I'm assuming drunk.
Drinking.
That's why you have it in the bowling alley, right?
I will say this. The parents of the boy who threw the party, I've actually have had social interactions with, and they're very nice.
Okay.
It wasn't their fault. Right. It was just, there were a lot of kids.
Right. Yeah. I get it. Didn't realize what they were getting themselves into.
I blame the bowling alley more. Like, they didn't really have someone there to, like, rein in the chaos, but whatever.
Right. You got to pay extra for that.
I guess.
At round one, they don't do that either. It's on you to make sure your kids aren't trying to break the
bowling
alley.
Well, you know, if it was like four kids, I could handle that. But 20, forget it. You're on your own.
Right. Ugh. I was just telling my son about my college friend who, during my fundraising event in college at a bowling alley, got super drunk and then threw himself down the lane and knocked over all the pins with his body and then got swept into the machine by the arm that comes down and just couldn't get out because he's very drunk, but every time he would go to get up to get out, the arm would come down to clear the air. It would clear him too, and they kicked us out.
No,
they kicked. Yeah, luckily,
you know, there was an episode of Bones where they found bones back there
in the gutter in the area behind the pins.
Yep.
Shit, yeah, it could have been my friend. The guy yelled at us because he said, you could have died doing that.
Yeah, it would have been that episode of Bones.
Right. And then the same friend tried to steal, I believe it was the bowling shoes and a bowling ball on the way out after we got kicked out. It's really good. Now he has two children and he's very responsible.
Well, half of that might be true.
No, he's peace. He doesn't do that stuff anymore.
I'm sure.
He used to piss on my... He would also pass out on my bed and piss himself.
Lovely. I had a friend once came to visit me. He's also now very responsible and successful. And I walked into the bathroom in the morning after a night of too much drinking and stuff. And he's brushing his teeth. And I go... Hey, we have the same toothbrush. And he looked at me and goes, no, we don't.
Or yes, we do. For today.
For today, we do.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I had to get a new toothbrush.
Yeah, and a new friend.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're still friends. Having dinner tomorrow.
All right, let's move on to Watch This, Bitches.
Yes, is Ship still here?
I am here.
Oh, okay, you got quiet. I was nervous.
He was brushing his teeth.
Okay. He didn't laugh at my toothbrushing story. I was like, that's a good story, damn it.
He doesn't like it. It grosses him out. He doesn't like those types of stories.
Not everyone was like, and then my friend won a Grammy. Yeah.
I think he's got like five. I don't know, four or five.
Right. He lost track.
Yeah, exactly.
He doesn't even know.
Mm-mm.
Watch This, Bitches. I rented Knives Out and watched it with the family.
And?
I would give it an 8 out of 10. I feel
that's
like...
pretty good.
I was expecting it to be funnier. It had a couple of good jokes, but not as many as Sonic.
Now, compared to, say, The Force Awakens, how was it?
Oh, I enjoyed it much more.
Okay. Same writer, director.
Correct. No, this movie made sense for the most part.
The Force Awakens?
It was like
Okay.
No, it did not. This was, you know, it's a classic, like, Agatha Christie-style murder mystery.
I very much want to see it. I just haven't.
Yeah, it just came available for rent this week, I think.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Been waiting to see. We were going to see it in the theater, but it just never happened. And Ty liked it.
I have it on my library wait list.
Yeah, there
you
go.
Oh, nice. That's a good call. I should do something like that.
I do that shit all the time. But not for movies, games.
That, and I need to see Joker still, I guess, right?
Yep.
All right. One of these days.
One of these days. Hey, let's talk about Harry's.
Sure. I love Harry's.
Yes. Wombat, what if there was a 50% off sale happening every time you went shopping for razors?
That's impossible.
What if, Wombat?
I don't know if I'd be mentally, like, I understand the words you're saying.
Right. You're not prepared for
but
this.
But mentally,
content.
I can't comprehend that actually being a thing that can happen.
Well, what if I told you that shaving with Harry's is kind of like that?
What?
They offer premium blade refills as low as $2.
Wait. They offer premium blade refills, but I'm sure they're expensive. They got to be like what? Like, I'm going to go with like $15 each.
They're as low as $2 each. That's up.
Did you say $2 each?
That's up to 55% off compared to the price of Gillette Fusion Pro Shield.
That's insanity because I use the Harry's blades and I would pay $15 for one blade.
Don't tell them that because then they're going to raise the prices.
Then you're telling me they're as low as $2 each.
That is what I am saying.
You're telling me for less than a price of a cup of coffee.
Well, sure.
That's insane.
I don't know where people get
I mean,
their
that's
coffee,
a, that's a, just an amazing value. That's all. Go ahead. Go on.
Well, I was just going to say that I've been using Harry's razor blades for a long time, of course, as you know, but I'm really most excited now about the face soap because I'm using it as like a full body soap because it's exfoliating. And I told you, like, my chest, if I don't use it, my chest breaks out. Try not to picture that. Actually, forget I said that. Wipe that visual image out of your mind. Hopefully you can't understand that concept. Like, Wombat can't understand the concept of cheap razor blades. But I use that. I have one tube of that in the shower and one tube of that on my kitchen sink for when I wash my face and I'm not in the shower. I don't wash my chest when I'm not in the shower. But I use it on my face and my chest when I'm in the shower. So Harry's, how do they do it? Well, the team combined a simple ergonomic design with five sharp blades, and they source their steel from Sweden and manufacture their blades in their world-class factory in Germany, and they cut out the middleman and ship directly to you, and that's how you save in the big, big money. And Harry's knows that a great shave doesn't come from flex balls or heated candles. They're a return to the essential. And the best part of all, there's no risk to you for trying them out. They stand behind the quality of their blades. If you don't love their shave, let them know. They'll give you a full refund. And Harry's has an amazing offer for listeners of our show. New customers get $5 off a trial set at harrys.com/cag. You'll get a 5-blade razor, weighted handle, foaming shave gel with aloe, and a travel cover. Join the millions of guys who are already saving money and go to harrys.com/cag to claim your offer. Do it.
Okay.
Not you, Wombat. You've done it.
Oh, I have. It's great.
You've done it all. All right, Shipwreck, it's time for you to do it.
Excellent. New releases time?
Yeah. Here we are.
Nice. The one that I'm most interested in this week is this Graham Blue Fantasy Versus.
The hell is that?
That is the new Arc Systems Works fighter.
Sounds like garbage.
It is currently sitting at a 78 on Metacritic. So
garbage numbers.
Not garbage.
Sounds like garbage. Is this for garbage people? Because it sounds like it's for garbage people too.
It doesn't tell me that right off.
I'm going to look at a picture and decide right now.
You should look at some of the videos of it. It's got...
It looks like it's got ladies with large chests in it.
I was going to guess. That was my first comment that I was going to make about when you mentioned it. And I said, you know what?
Some of those, I think. It's got a very cool art style for a fighting game.
It looks fine. Is this like a Blaze Blue? Is that why there's blue in it?
Well, I mean, it's from Arc Systems Works. So it's the same company that makes Blaze Blue.
But it's not related.
Not related to Blaze Blue.
They just both made by the same company. Both have blue in the title. Both are fighting games, but they have nothing to do with each other.
Right.
Okay, just check it.
You've nailed all of those things.
I'm watching a fighting tournament.
Okay.
Of the game. This guy just lost. He's taking his controller with him and going home.
Okay.
Oh, he lost to a guy with a joypad. This guy brought this big fucking thing. Oh, maybe he won. I don't know. How the fuck do I know who won? Anyway, it's very exciting for me to do play-by-play on this guy wrapping up his controller. All right, it looks fine. I like the art style. I'm not going to touch it, though.
That's fine.
The breasts were too small.
Well, yeah. I think Grand Blue is an RPG series.
Yeah, yeah. It's known for its small breasts.
Okay.
That's their small breast line of games.
So it's a fighting game based on a franchise that none of us know, but I like Arc System Works fighting games, and it looks very
sold.
Cheapy, I know that you may know something about One Punch Man.
I don't.
No!
I don't. It's called A Hero Nobody Knows, and I am one of those nobodies that knows, doesn't know. What?
Mm-hmm.
I know that he's bald and wears a yellow outfit and has a cape.
Right, just like
I'm
you.
I'm assuming that when he only needs to punch people once because he's that strong.
Man.
He's a one-punch man. It's all it takes is one punch. Yeah. How many punches did it take you, Wombat?
About half.
Half a punch?
Half punch, man.
What's a half a punch?
That's like, you know, you go in for the punch.
And then
and the guy goes down.
That's good.
What the hell was that? And then he walks away.
We finally found a way to beat One Punch Man.
So is this game good or what?
I doubt it. I bet it's fine. It's a Namco Bandai game about an anime.
I saw they're making another My Hero game.
Okay.
Did you
go see whatever that is in the theaters?
I saw we saw the first one on, we rented it.
Oh.
But they came out with another one this weekend. Or last weekend. Yeah. We didn't see that one. But Ty, did I tell you that when Ty wore his My Hero, one of his My Hero shirts in Florida, everybody like came up to him to talk about My Hero. Like, we went to one restaurant, like a, it's like one of those bowl places, like, you know, you choose the ingredients and they put it together for you in a bowl.
Mm-hmm. And oh, you go down I thought you meant like a weed store.
Yeah, yeah, went to a weed store and Ty was smoking his bowls. You know, like you go down the line and, you know, okay, I want the chicken, I want the broccoli, whatever.
Yes.
Every time Ty went down the line, the guy was like, oh, I really like your shirt. Love My Hero. Like, just, it was one after another. It was ridiculous. It was like a joke.
Okay.
And
did he give
him
extra chicken?
He could, if he wanted, he probably could have scored it. Especially if he started speaking Japanese and stuff. Because these guys were way into it. You know what I'm saying?
I do.
And then we went to a museum, and we were just at the museum, and there was some class trip went by, and the kids were like whispering, you know, talking about, hey, look at his shirt, look at his shirt.
Like, what about when you went for stone crabs? Were they into it when you went for stone crabs?
No. Did we go for stone crabs?
I think you did have stone crabs. You sent that picture of the seafood platter. Looked like a stone crab claw in the middle.
No. I'm not sure that was my claw.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not sure I had access to that claw.
Oh, that's a shame. Because stone crabs are amazing. And you can only get them in Florida.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Missed out.
Right. Anyway.
I would have said go get stone crabs, but then you sent the picture and I'm like, oh, you must have had it. But I guess not.
Yeah. I don't know what I was eating at that point. Crab cakes, probably.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry to disappoint.
It's okay.
I don't like to have to do that much work when I'm eating.
And hey, did we get crab? I think we were eating crab cakes at the same time on our trips. How weird.
That is weird.
Mm-hmm.
But it's much less work eating a crab cake.
And I bet both of ours were delicious in their own way.
It was delicious, and I did not cut my fingers during the meal, which is nice.
I didn't know how good the crab cakes were going to be at the place I was, but since it was an all-inclusive, I had them bring me out the turkey also in case the
what? Crab cakes were left. At Woodlock you did that?
Yeah. Oh.
How did – wait, did – like your parents were there watching the kids?
No. The kids were at the table with me.
Oh, that was in that. That was at, not at the adults only side.
No. That was at the regular dining room.
Got it. I thought you were doing that in the adults only side of that.
No, place. No. At the all inclusive for dinner the night they had the crab cakes.
All right.
I said to my wife, "Do you think the crab cakes here are any good?" And she says, "I don't know." I'm like, "The turkey sounds good too." So I said to the waiter, "What do you recommend? The crab cakes or the turkey?" And the waiter said, "I'll bring out both, and you could decide."
Right. You win. You said that's what I wanted you to say.
Yeah, no, that was the right answer.
And also, here are some extra bobbleheads I have.
And to be honest, the turkey was kind of meh, but the crab cakes were excellent.
You got the surf and turf.
Exactly. It's weird. Perfect. Surf and turf, though.
Well, it works.
Yeah, I guess.
Hey, you fucking ate it.
I did.
I think you're the only person that's ever ordered turkey and crab cakes.
I might be, but it is very common there for people to get, like, multiple entrees. Like, when we got back... Actually, at the bowling party, I was talking to one of the moms who knew where we just were. And she's like, oh, yeah, my husband, every time we go there, he gets like three of every entree. I'm like, that's kind of gross. But, you know, I didn't ask for both entrees. The waiter said, I'll bring you both entrees. I feel like there's a difference there.
That's the Thanksgiving surf and turf.
The Thanksgiving. Exactly. Yep. They call it the Plymouth Rock.
Right. Mm-hmm. Delicious. Ugh. Actually, it sounds fucking disgusting.
Don't eat both at the same time.
What if you wrapped the crab cake in the turkey?
That would be gross. I didn't, though. I did.
It's like
I
a just turducken.
I wound up really just not eating the turkey.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. It's hard to make good turkey.
It is. You know, it's not that the turkey was bad. It's just the crab cakes were that much better.
Delicious.
Mm-hmm.
All right, are we still in new releases or are we in the crab cake section?
You tell me what new release is worth talking about that's better than crab cakes.
Well, we have I Am Ball for the Switch. Sounds pretty good.
Okay.
We also have Stab, Stab, Stab for the Switch.
That's also out for Xbox One.
Oh, stab away. And that's it. Ski sniper.
Excuse me?
Frozen friends.
Frozen friends for stab here?
Bucket knight?
Mm.
Oh, I know. Be a walker.
Pocket pool?
Pocket pool's out again?
No.
Oh, that's
there's
Pop must be
there's
pocket
bucket
too.
Knight. You like all those knight games, Cheapy?
Yeah, no, I know. I just said that one. Who could forget? All right, let's move on.
I forgot.
Let's move on. Right, we all forgot. Let's move on. Oh, I know what I want to talk about that I didn't forget. I'm gonna put this on the outline here. Okay, let's do news, multi-platforming, and Wombat's Rainbow Sexy Talk. I guess the big news of the week, which you actually watched it sort of unfold in real time on Twitter, was GDC's postponement. Is the plan to still have GDC?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I don't know who. It's kind of a tough thing to just do again. I think you're just looking, waiting until next year. That's my guess.
Right. I thought they.
The original announcement was something about postponing it until the summer.
Right. That's what I thought I read.
Yeah, but I mean,
people's schedules kind of fill up. Like, that's going to be tough to.
And it's also the Olympics, and there's a lot going on this summer.
I like how you went straight there's also the Olympics. Like, the same people that were going to attend GDC are also competing in Olympic events.
I just mean, like, airfare and is going to be sometimes.
But the Olympics are in Tokyo. The Olympics are in Tokyo, and GDC's not in Tokyo.
I know. It's in San Francisco, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Those are different.
People, if you're flying to Tokyo, may stop at San Francisco.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Why not?
There's a correlation there. Don't gaslight me.
I'm going to give it to you.
Thank you.
I'm going to let you have it.
Yeah.
Yeah, no problem.
That's also shortly after D3. I mean, how much time are people really
Olympics try to hold themselves like every 4 years just so they don't interfere with GDC, which is a yearly.
Right.
Oh, that's duh. But although they may cancel the Olympics too, so who knows?
that would suck. Can you imagine how bad that would suck if you had like planned your life around training for the Olympics?
If you're going to the Olympics,
most of those athletes have like structured their last 4 years to get to this moment,
right? Which means they've played that sport 8 hours a day.
Well, yeah, and they had very specific training regimens to where they would peak at this time.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Sucks.
Yeah, of course.
Yep.
Yeah. Hopefully it happens. It still takes place. Yep. But so GDC will not take place, and I agree with you. It does seem unlikely that they'll be able to postpone that. We're going to postpone it for a year, basically. let's see. Chaos Martinez writes in, I don't know, I fucked his name up, but whatever. If E3 was this week, would you still attend? If the corona outbreak is still in full effect when it actually is, would you attend? If it was this week, no, I would not attend. Shipwreck?
Just because of the virus?
Yeah. I think they would probably cancel it if it was this week.
Yeah, they probably would.
I'm pretty sure it would be canceled. The GDC was canceled.
If it was not canceled, I would still attend.
Okay.
I don't know. I'd have an easier time going now than I would in June.
Because it's not near the Olympics, obviously.
It's not near the Olympics. It's not wedged during the same exact time as my nephew's wedding and my son's birthday. So, that would make it a lot easier.
That's the Wombat Olympics.
Oh, it's going to be a nightmare for me in June. So, hooray.
So what if, I think what Shipwreck is saying, if they're having E3, he's going. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Have E3, unless, will travel.
Unless the corona situation gets bad.
Well, then I assume that they would cancel it.
Cancel.
I don't know.
That makes sense.
I mean, think of it this way. No lines. Mm?
I've been to that E3. It's not bad.
Right.
Yeah. No
more time for activations.
I think so many activations. The real thing is that all the companies would pull out.
Right.
Multiple
t-shirts.
What
happened to GDC?
You get like two t-shirts.
The t-shirts aren't coming, Wombat. That's the issue.
They don't live there. The companies need to bring them. They don't just grow there. It's not their natural habitat. But you did watch, like, on Twitter, you saw all the companies pull out of GDC, like, one after another.
Yeah, in real time. It was fun.
Right. It was pretty interesting. It was, it was like, musty Twitter for some reason. I don't know. I was, like, glued to Twitter, like, oh, my God. I've never even been to GDC. Okay. What else we got here?
You could go. I'm sure they'd be happy to have you, like, next year.
I have a lot of family responsibilities. I can't just be like flying off to gaming conventions whenever
that's
I want.
Such phony baloney, but okay.
That's what? In what way is that phony baloney?
You have another person in your house that could pick up someone from school for 2 days.
She can't. She doesn't drive, and she works much later than those things.
Mm-hmm.
She's very important at her work. They need her.
Mm-hmm.
She's big time.
That I don't doubt.
Right. No, she's, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Soon Ty will be old enough and...
Ty does not need someone to be at the house when he gets home from school.
No. He doesn't have that. But he needs someone sometime to pick him up. You know, it's dark out. It's a 20-minute walk home.
Mm-hmm.
It's winter.
You know what? It's funny because we're having this conversation now. When my daughter gets to high school...
Okay.
We're considered to be too close for buses.
Okay.
Right now, we're distance enough where we got buses, so she could take the bus home, and that's great. But when we get to the high school, we're considered too close for buses. Here's the problem. The way they calculate it is by drawing a straight line from your house to the high school.
Right. That's
what they don't take into account is the Southern State Parkway.
Right.
And you can't cross the Southern State Parkway because there's fences with barbed wire.
Right.
So you can't, like, you know, just like, there's no pedestrian bridge. She has to walk, like, 15 minutes around to get to where you can cross over and through. Where if you calculated it by actual driving distance,
right,
we would qualify for a bus.
Just get her an Uber every day.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, do I have to fight the school board on this one? It's very annoying. I have 2 years, though, so.
Right. You could start writing to them now.
Now? Yeah, I know.
You just be nice about it.
My wife's friends was saying that their daughter, who's in high school, she just gets on one of the buses that she knows stops closer to the house, and they don't stop her.
Right. That's another way to probably do it.
Yeah. Like, oh, I guess you could do that.
Ow.
Mm-hmm.
All right, where are we here?
Multiplatforming.
Apex Legends has got some good stuff going on.
You said you were going to play with me. You haven't played with me yet.
I've been playing, though. I've been playing with myself, and it's been going great.
That's good.
I've been getting some kills. There's some big new update called System Override, and I think they're really just experimenting on us at this point. You know, EA loves to experiment on their audience. So they're coming out with a mode that has no random loot. So the loot spawns in the same spot every time. So the whole randomization of the game is taken out. And I think it's really just to collect data, like to see how much less popular this version of the game is. I don't know. Actually, I'm curious to see what happens. But I feel like it's going to take away a lot of the appeal if you know where the loot is every time. But what do I know? There's some other things probably involved in this event, but that was the big part that I saw. The other big story this week was somebody came out with a gaming bed. This was one of the hottest stories on my Feedly feed. This is the dumbest thing ever. Would anybody ever... like put one of these things. It just looks like a bed with a beanbag on top of it and a bunch of desks around it.
I saw that.
The desks look like you don't need them.
No,
for the most part.
Who needs a desk at the end of their bed?
Right. What's that? He's got speakers on the end of it, but why? You could probably put those speakers somewhere else.
Yeah.
This looks like a dumb, just like a thing to make a meme out of. I don't like it. I don't like that it got so popular.
Mm-mm.
I'm against these types of news items.
Yeah, you let them have it.
Yeah. I'm so against it that I read it on the show.
Mm-hmm.
We've been playing a lot of Children of Morta still in this household. It's definitely the most popular game right now. Mrs. Chibi demands to play it every night. She's getting better, which is good. Do you still play that game, Wombat?
I haven't played it in a while. I got so sidetracked with other things, but I should go back, shouldn't I?
Yes, Shipwreck, you need to get on this with Mrs. Ship, because you guys are actually good at games. Mm-hmm. I think you'll have a lot of fun with it.
We'll get on it. Because
it's Diablo. It's basically Diablo with, you know, old school graphics and sort of just easier.
We're on to the DLC portion of Borderlands 3, so.
That is important.
Yep, we're getting
there. Wombat, did you unlock the girl with the flame hands?
No. I know she's there, though.
Yes.
She's in the house, but I can't play as her yet.
No. I'm very excited. She's very good.
That does not surprise me. She has flame hands.
Lucy is her name.
Mm-hmm.
I know all their names. Don't worry.
That's awesome.
Ask me the names. I'll not tell you the names.
What are their names?
John.
Mm-hmm.
Mark.
Mm-hmm.
Lucy.
Mm-hmm.
Linda.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's... Oh, no, there's one more. Shit, Kevin. That's it. There's probably some that you unlock that I don't have yet.
Okay.
There you go. Children of Morta on Game Pass. You got to check it out. It's really good. That's all. That's all we play. What else we got here in your whatever section?
I played a little bit more of Division 2 because it was $3 and I bought it, you know, whatever. And that game is really good looking.
Okay.
It's a very good looking game. I know they had
tired of the whole concept of just putting bullets into things.
I find that relaxing. So to each their own.
Sure.
That's how I wind down, is by shooting things. Imaginary things.
Uh-huh.
But it's a very good looking game. They had the big update this week to go with the big expansion. I haven't played it since the update. I wanted to play it last night, but I didn't realize it hadn't updated yet. So I had to wait for the 60 gigabyte update to finish. And by then I was sleepy. So that was that. And I'll probably play it tomorrow/today for those listening. But yeah, I enjoy it. The more I play it, the more I like it. But who knows? We'll see. We'll see I think with the update, they're supposed to like improve the loot system.
I'm glad you're getting your $3 worth.
Yeah, why not, right?
Sure.
It is, and I think I mentioned this, it's a weird thing to go to from Breakpoint, because the games are very similar, but all the controls are completely different. So it's a little disorienting at times, but that's more my fault than the games.
I agree.
Mm-hmm.
All right, then.
Mm-hmm.
Let's move on to the stadium. Enter the stadium.
Yeah.
You got another article from Ben Gilbert.
From Ben Gilbert. It's two Ben Gilberts in a row.
Uh-huh.
Now, are you familiar with the Stadia?
No. Actually, I just heard of it, actually.
So there's like no games on it.
Uh-huh.
And one of the reasons why is because Stadia isn't paying enough to get games on it.
Yeah, I would think they would have to pay what's known as a premium to get games on there, and it turns out that they're
trying to be, because they're Google.
They don't have any money or any resources.
Yeah, I feel like they think that they don't have to, maybe.
Oh, like it's a privilege to be on their platform?
Yeah.
That's a bad attitude.
I'm just saying, I have no idea why they wouldn't try to get more games.
What are they going to do with more games?
I don't know.
How many games can you play at one time, Wombat?
I mean, I could play like 17, but I'm weird. Right.
They have 17 games.
Yeah.
See?
Stadia. We have at least 17 games.
Mm-hmm.
Probably more.
So the question is, how much longer are we really giving Stadia? Do you think at this time next year, we're going to be talking about Stadia because it's a thing that they're still releasing content for? Or are we going to talk about Stadia the same way we talk about the Zune?
It seems... I don't know.
The Zune was a bigger hit than this, right?
Yes, the Zune was a bigger hit than this.
I feel like the whole like Founders Edition shit was just like a move to see if they could clean out a few suckers. You know, like they realized that they didn't really have much to offer, but the plan was in place to put out this thing to have a special edition. And maybe they're not in a rush for this thing to catch on that quickly. And probably the goal is to have it be a free product, just like their competitors, because it's kind of hard to charge for something that your competitors are not charging for. So, yeah. So maybe they're in it for a long haul and they're just, I don't know, just trying to grab the money while they can. But then again, if they don't get any new games on there, it's going to be tough.
Mm-hmm. Especially when you don't really own the games and you're expected to pay full price for games. I don't know. I still have no idea how that thing works.
Right. No one does.
Nope.
Stupid. It's a mystery.
Stupid.
All right. Let's move on to my stupid PC, PC, PC corner. It's been a while since we've been here.
Ugh. What's on your PC?
Have you guys watched the new Half-Life Alyx gameplay trailer?
You know, I've never played. Actually, no. I think I did play Half-Life 2.
Okay.
And the orange box, right? Remember that?
Yeah. Yes, I do, of course.
Yeah, I think I never finished it, but I think I missed the boat on Half-Life where it has no meaning for me. Does that make sense?
That's fine, okay.
So I'm like, yeah, whatever.
You say, well, did you watch the gameplay videos at all?
No, because I don't care.
This is the VR game, by the way.
It's a VR game on PC. Why would I pay any attention to it?
Well, because it's kind of a big deal in that it's a Half-Life game.
Again,
first.
Something that doesn't... one thing A that doesn't interest me. No, let's go on.
Oh, I understand. But just because something doesn't interest you personally doesn't...
You asked me if I watched it. I'm not saying it's not something that you can talk about. And
I watched it, and I don't plan on playing it because I don't have a system that can play it, but I still watch the video to check it out because I thought it might be interesting.
And
it was interesting.
Why?
It's okay. I'll tell you why.
Tell me why.
They've managed to, first of all, like the fundamentals of the game look really solid in terms of like the graphics look better than any VR game that I've seen. I don't know. Honestly, I don't know how that's going to translate to the screen 3 inches from your eye. But because it looked really slick on my phone. But they also seem to get the shooting down really well and the character movement, because it is a first-person shooter / puzzler.
Mm-hmm.
It looked like it would be fun to shoot those. I forgot what all the different characters in Half-Life are called. But, you know, those little, like, alien crab looking dudes. And I don't know, it looked fun. I guess that's the best thing I could say about it. It looked like a fun, high quality game.
All right.
And I liked how I'm not super familiar with Half-Life, but I played through the two Half-Life games. Probably two I played through.
Is Team Fortress still a thing?
Probably.
Right? That was a big deal for a long time. Whatever happened to Team Fortress?
I'm sure it's doing fine.
Is it? I mean, I don't doubt you. It's just weird that you don't hear about it much anymore.
Right. It's time for...
Or is it not weird? Or is
they must be up. They must be working on a new version of that.
Right? Like Team Fortress 3.
Yeah. That's a good name for it.
Team Fortress BR.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, just
something.
Something.
You think?
Yeah. Just, you know.
Anyway, I don't know. I don't think that Half-Life Alyx is going to sell a lot of VR hardware necessarily. I think people who have the systems will be pretty excited, and some people might be the thing that pushes them over, but it's not going to be the thing that makes VR like a household thing. Not at all. But it looks really cool. It looks so cool that I watched there's three different trailers. And I stopped watching because I thought, maybe I will play this sometime. That's how cool it looks. All right, let's move on. Oh, no, I also wanted to talk about another game that I've been playing. Well, I mean, a game that I've been playing that's pretty hot recently, called Escape from Tarkov. Have you heard of that?
Yes.
Yes.
Do you know anything about it?
No.
Wombat?
No.
See, me neither. So I bought it so I could talk about
okay.
it.
Okay.
It was the only way I could figure out what it was. It's a persistent online, not persistent, okay. You have a persistent character and it's an online shooter, loot shooter. So you'll jump in, you have a character, and if you die in the game, any loot that you have is lost in the game. Unless it was in like a special box that you're carrying. So you're basically trying to find better weapons and stuff. And you can also play, if you want to play, but you don't want to play as your character, because you only have one, you can play as like a computer generated character, and you don't get any experience when you use that, but you can still bring back loot for your main character. And the whole idea is to get through a map and escape at the end of the map. There's like certain exits, and you have to, usually there's some objective that needs to be met before you can escape. I don't know. It's pretty cool. I don't really understand what's going on most of the time, like what I need to do to escape. I've never successfully escaped, and I barely found anything worth keeping.
Have you found any pocket watches?
No pocket watches. I found some duct tape and some bullets and stuff. Maybe a gun or two, but I've never escaped to keep them. So, yeah. Anyway, it's in beta right now. And if you pre-order it, you get access to the beta. That's what I'm trying to say. So that's that. Let's move on to the Apple Orchard.
Sure. The new Apple Arcade game this week was from Hipster Whale, the Crossy Road people.
Oh, yeah. So is it the same kind of game?
So Crossy Castle is the name of the game. It uses the same like pixel style animal characters. Mm-hmm. So I think maybe I've only played as the chicken. I'm not sure. I know that's who I played as my most recent game. It's a platforming game with very short levels. Seems like it's just like a continuous type thing. Like I got up to like level 24 and I hadn't died or anything. But then I kind of started losing interest in it. It's odd because it's like, it has that repetitive gameplay that like made Crossy Road fun.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not as random or like.
Do you unlock a lot of characters?
I haven't unlocked anything yet because like every time I stop playing, like I'm like, oh, well, I played for like my 5 minutes and I put it in pause. And then every time I come back, it's like, oh, you're starting over again. So
you're playing it wrong.
Sounds bad.
I don't know. I haven't figured out the rhythm of this game yet. Like it keeps my coins. And maybe okay. I'm going to spend those coins on something. I don't know.
I think that's what you're supposed to do. I've always been more of a fan of Disney Crossy Road.
Sure.
Which they don't support anymore, which is kind of a bummer.
Well.
But, yeah. But, yeah. All right.
Yep. So, Crossy Castle.
Fine.
And I Apple beat Roller Coaster Tycoon Story.
Mazel.
Mm-hmm.
That's not on the arcade. That is, so obviously Atari published that.
Mm-hmm.
So it has microtransactions in it, but I cannot fathom why anybody would ever need them or let alone purchase them.
Since you finished the game without,
like I completely
did you pay
finished,
nothing?
Yeah, I completely finished the game and I never ran out of any of the things.
Oh.
Yeah, so I'd be interested to see, like, what their revenue stream is on this game.
Yeah. Good luck, Atari. Speaker hats.
Mm-hmm.
I saw a banner ad for speaker shoes today.
Oh.
How do you I don't, whatever.
I don't know. I couldn't even, like, I was like, I just rolled my eyes so hard when I saw the ad. I fucking just got right out of there. So I was, while we're in the iPhone section, Ty's iPhone has been acting really weird recently. He's got like an old iPhone 7 that I put a new battery in. Not me personally. I hired.
I understand. You
know. And it's been like resetting, like just like rebooting and shit, and to the point where he's got to carry a battery around with him. It's been really annoying. So I was looking at the phone today just to see like if I could figure out what's going on. And I noticed like the case wasn't fitting properly on the phone. And I was like, dude, what'd you do to this phone? Like the case, you don't even have the case on right. How did you mess this up? Did you drop it or something? He's like, no, it's been like that for a little while now. And I'm like, what's going on here? And I take the case off and the whole phone is like, I think the battery like puffed up or something.
And that does happen.
Yeah. And it just like completely separated the phone. The phone is totally.
You got to get him a new, you have to get him a new phone.
So, yeah, I know. So the new phone is supposed to come out. They're supposed to come out with a $400 phone at the end of March. And it's, you know, so that's my choice. That's the cheapest option, I'm pretty sure. But we have I found an old iPhone 5 in the house, but it's so old that the only way to like get the latest software on there is to plug it into a computer. You can't do over the air update. So that's what I'll be doing after the show tonight, is trying to get Ty's phone into an iPhone 5.
Good luck with that. iPhone 5, that's a couple iterations back.
Should I not even bother? Like, what am I supposed to do in this situation?
I would say, who's your service with? Not that it matters. Whoever you're
Verizon.
Okay, go to a Verizon store and say you need a phone for your son and see what's available. Sometimes even if like you upgrade your plan or somehow with an extra.
They're going to try to trick me into getting into their unlimited plan.
Something. I'm just saying. I'm trying to help. You never know. You could also say no thank you and walk away.
They try to trick you into the unlimited plan because in the unlimited plan, they can put you on the slow network.
Oh, I'm on the slow network. I know it sucks.
And they keep trying to, I'm like on the 12 gigabyte plan or something, and they keep trying unlimited. I'm like, no, I know what you're trying to do.
There's two versions of the unlimited. If I spent an extra $10 a month, I'd be on the regular network.
I see.
I just haven't made that phone call yet, and I'm also cheap.
Right.
So.
See, I'm going to do nothing.
Mm-hmm. I'm also on Wi-Fi significantly more than I'm not on Wi-Fi.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we're going to learn how well iTunes works on Windows 10.
Good luck.
Tonight. This is going to be awesome. All right, let's move on to the CAG bag. Busta Upper writes in and wants to know about our thoughts on the Switch version of Witcher 3 offering cross-save with Steam and good old games. Seems like a pretty win-win prospect to me. Apparently, a few other Switch games have offered PC cross-save as well, so I hope this continues to catch on.
Sure.
I like this concept in general and across any platform, any game.
Yeah, it's just good for the consumer who, you know, doesn't have to worry about the choice they make. Ruining their chances of, you know, getting improvements later or playing with friends or whatever it might be. Yes, it's right. A very consumer-facing proposition.
I wish Apex Legends had that feature.
Sure.
I would play with more other people. Or I'd rather not play with other people. Like I'm not playing with you.
Exactly.
Shanafan writes in and asks, do you think we're at the point where controllers have reached their maximum potential? For example, if you compared an NES controller to an Xbox One controller, the transition was huge. However, in the past 20 years, controllers have stayed relatively the same. Could there be a new enhancement to a controller that would blow people's minds?
I don't know about blow people's minds. I mean, yes, the Elite has the cool back paddles.
Nah, but that's the same.
But it's, like I said, that's not really blowing anyone's mind. Or even like the rubberized grip on the.
No. Yeah, he's talking about evolution.
I know. I'm just saying. Like I'm like getting there.
Yeah, we haven't had any real evolution at all.
Not
adding
not
more buttons doesn't count.
No, we definitely that does not count. Yeah, no, I mean, it's a pretty good controller.
Yeah,
I don't know what to tell you. They did a good job. You know, they figured it out. I don't know.
It could be better. I feel like there is room for improvement somehow.
There's always room for improvement.
How could one controller, like the one size controller, be good for every size hand? It doesn't make any sense.
I don't know, considering that your hands are like 9 times the size of mine, and yet we still use the same controllers.
That's what I'm saying. How could that be?
I don't know.
Could that be ideal for both of us?
Different size controllers isn't a major adjustment in controller technology.
It's not.
Different size controllers.
What if there were like little knobbies that we could attach to our fingertips?
That sounds annoying.
And then, okay, what if, I don't know. I got nothing. And if I had something good, I'm keeping it to myself.
Yeah, there you go.
For making that big gains. All right. Where are we here? At Carl Kramer writes in and wants to know what Shipwreck's opinion on the new G.I. Joe figures is.
So the new G.I. Joe figures, the G.I. Joe Classified, these are equivalent of like the Marvel Legends line.
Yes, so, same $20.
So $20, 6-inch figures. I don't. They're $20 6-inch figures. It's a lot.
Yeah,
and they don't look like other than Snake Eyes, who always looks like Snake Eyes. Like they've only messed him up a couple times throughout G.I. Joe figures. All the rest of them were like, okay, that's a version of Duke, I guess. Like they made a blonde guy with a scar.
Right. I don't like his face or hair.
Right. So yeah, I think I will pick up Snake Eyes when Destro comes out. I'll probably pick up Destro.
Zartan.
I don't know. Like, I don't like the Roadblock.
Is it a build-a-figure thing too, or is it not?
I don't.
It's made by the same people.
I don't think it is, but I don't know. I don't know what you would be building.
I could see like Serpentor build-a-figure. That's like a thing.
It doesn't. None of the pictures have shown any kind of build-a-figure stuff.
Okay. Big Lob. Big
Lob. I like Roadblock.
Could be a build-a-figure.
I like Roadblock.
You do like Roadblock.
I don't know. I'm just not. I'm never a fan of action figures that aren't designed for children to play with.
Yeah, like I was kind of. I was kind of hoping when I heard there's a new G.I. Joe line that it was going to be
something you could buy for your kids to play with and have the same enjoyment you had as a child.
Something along those lines.
Yeah. Yeah. Because I was disappointed too.
I just feel like these aren't going to sell well. And so
it's going to ruin the G.I. Joe business?
No, because there is no G.I. Joe business currently.
Exactly.
Right?
G.I. Joe doesn't. Oh. There hasn't been new G.I. Joes in forever. So
Roadblock's gun is incredibly long.
I don't know what's going on with it. It's like some like.
It's longer than he is tall.
That's fine. That's a traditional Roadblock thing. Like he's.
It is? What's the physics on that?
Roadblock has always been like carrying around like a turret with him.
Okay. Okay.
But I don't know it's what really this long. Thing is that he's carrying around. It's got like.
It has a bottle opener.
Electronic gadgets on it or something. I don't know what's going on.
Cattle prod. Some sort of air fryer.
It's just weird. Like they don't quite look like any existing G.I. Joe property.
Razzmatazz. Right. Is that what he says?
I don't know. All right.
Yeah.
Let's move on. At Knight Rider 487. All right, Knight Rider. Thoughts on the Final Fantasy VII remake demo? I was blown away on how it looked and played. Okay. We haven't played it.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
I'm not familiar.
I never played it originally. I doubt I'll play it now.
Right.
Exactly. I want to play it. I just have not had a chance between when it came out and this show.
Because right. You're too I'm busy more interested playing in Borderlands.
Sure.
I'm more interested in a Knight Rider remake. Knight Rider.
Knight Rider is the game?
No. TV show.
That game was pretty lame.
What was the game?
They made a NES Knight Rider game.
Yeah.
It was bad. It was pretty bad.
Yeah. I remember reading about
it. I want to say it was an LJN special.
Yeah. That sounds right.
Mm-hmm. And didn't they try rebooting Knight Rider like 3 times now?
Yeah, it wasn't good.
No. That show doesn't.
It can be done, though, I feel.
Can it? I'd rather see an A-Team reboot. They haven't tried that recently.
A-Team?
Movie.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah.
They tried that.
Not a TV show.
Fair.
Yeah, I want to see an A-Team TV show reboot.
All right. At Ed's Head writes in and says, this is a good question since you all have Game Pass. He's quantifying that his question is good. That's good. I would love Game Pass via xCloud on the Switch. Curious about your thoughts. And then Huff at Hufferstall says, is there any chance Sony and Microsoft will allow streaming games to the opposite platforms as long as you're paying for xCloud, etc.? So pretty much the same question.
I don't know. I mean, it wouldn't be bad, I guess, if you'd like playing your games on the Switch.
It's a screen with a controller attached to it in this case. That's the function that it would be performing if it was streaming xCloud. It seems unlikely that that's going to happen, I feel.
Yeah.
They're going to have to figure out how they all get paid. That seems contentious and difficult.
Yep.
I think we've made it to the end of the show.
That's exciting.
And you were worried, Wamba, that we didn't have enough stuff to talk about. That was Shipwreck who was worried. Oh, hold on. Three more seconds. Made it. Nice. Mm-hmm. All right. Let's remind everybody that new customers will get $5 off a Harry's trial set when they go to harrys.com/gag. And let's remind everybody to follow us on Twitter at GPD, at New Wombat, at Shipwreck, at Video Game Deals. Anything else we need to remind people, Wombat?
Bread's done?
Cobra Commander, he is the enemy. He's the enemy of G.I. Joe.
He's escaping!
He's escaping in the Cobra Claw! Get the Nick Jaws and get him aboard the Skyhawk!
Introducing Duke, Roadblock, and Spirit.
G.I. Joe, the real American hero. G.I. Joe is there.
Cobra Commander got away! But we captured Storm Shadow. Yo, Joe!
G.I. Joe Skyhawk. Joe and Cobra figures and Cobra Claw sold separately from Hasbro.